Hey Joe, what's up?
Oh, not much. I've got some data and I think I've got it in the right format. I was wondering if you could show me how to get it onto R so I could start running those important statistical tests.
Okay. You sound pretty earnest there, Joe.
Oh, I'm trying.
You're raring to go with this data analysis, huh? All right. Well, let's see what we can do. I'm in our studio right here, and we're on the server version that we use so much in class. So this is actually something coming to you over the internet, right? It's not on your computer. So if you want to get stuff into the R server, you're going to have to upload it, just like you might upload a picture to your Facebook profile or something like that. So let's see what we might find. Well, on the files pane, there is an upload files to server. Let's see if it will help us.
Isn't that handy?
Yeah, mighty handy. Okay, so we browse our computer to find the file. And I believe we had it on the desktop.
I think that's right.
Let me see, desktop. And I'll troll around the desktop. And oh my goodness, there is, I believe that's the data set that you want, the duckweed data set. So I'll click on it and press open. And there's the duckweed.csv. Looks like it's ready to be uploaded. Okay, and if I, oh look, there it is
There it is.
in my home directory. But you know what? Say you're planning to use it for a data project, you might create a directory just for the stuff with your data project. And I happen to have one here called Data Project. Why don't we go ahead and move it into that directory?
Sounds like a good
Yeah,
idea.
so I'm going to click it. Click Duckweed and let me look for more options here. See if I could move it. Move. Alrighty. We'll move it into Data Project. Choose that. And it disappears from our files pane. I hope it didn't go for good. Let's open Data Project. There it is. Lucky.
Had me
All
on the
right.
edge of my seat
Really?
the whole
Okay.
time.
What we need to do is to get this data set into a format that R understands as a data frame. Now, there's various ways to do it, but we'll try to teach you just one. Look up here, import data set. Let's see what you could do it from a text file, or you could even do it from something you find on the internet. We have it as a text file here, already uploaded. So we'll go for text file. And we're pointed to our home directory. So I think if we look inside Data Project, there it is. So I guess if I just ask to open it. So I see you have a nasty problem with your data set. It looks to me like you have the two variables you were interested in, Franz and location, but you got these other variables too. Everything looks good. Everything else looks good. I mean, you asked for headings, and so it tells you the names of those variables. This part, the first two columns, look okay, but the last four columns do not. Tell you what, let's just accept this thing and make a data frame out of it and then just deal with it. So we'll import it. Kawomp. Let's check out the global environment. Oh, look there, duckweed.
There all
Yeah,
along.
38 observations of six variables. And over in the view pane, it just for free showed us a view of it. And you've got these four extra things that were probably left over from some kind of editing operation you were doing in Excel. And invisible to you were four columns that Excel thought had values in them. Yeah, now this happens more than you'd like it to happen. But it's all right. Let me show you what you can do. So rather than go back to Excel and somehow make sure those columns are blank, let's go to console here. And I'm going to say duckweed, dollar sign capital X. I'm going to put null into it. It's a way of making it go away. Check duckweed now in the global environment.
It's already changed.
It's only 5 variables. All right, let me do an up arrow key. Get the same command back. And let's go and find the other name of the variable was that. So we got rid of the x, but how about the x.1? We need to get rid of that. So x.1. Okay, let's get rid of x.2. Up arrow key, edit. And we need to get rid of this x.3. All right. Tell you what, why don't we ask to view duckweed again just to see if everything is looking good. And in the view window, that looks nice. And check over in your global environment. Duckweed is there, and it's 38 observations of 2 variables. That's what we want.
Yeah, my biology professors will be proud. Thank you, Dr.
Thanks, Warren. This is interesting. Can I keep the data?
You can have it.
Whoa! See ya. Thank you all for listening.